Trees can also be used for search very conveniently. There are so-called search trees. This is a data structure for locating specific keys from a set. And with such a data structure, search operation, where you search for a specific key, is a dominantly used function that we try to optimize for. So when we try to create such a tree that does this efficiently, we can create it using a property. And the property is that the key for the node must be higher than any key in the descendants on the left, but smaller than any keys in the descendants on the right. So that is really an interesting property. Let's have a look how this works. Here we have a binary subtree that is not fully populated. Null means we have no child. So let's find out how this works. So let's assume we're searching here for the number, let's say 32. So we know, we look at this node here, we know this node here is bigger than the left-hand side, but smaller than the right-hand side, so the right children, right? So when we compare it with 32, we know, okay, 32 is smaller than 42, so we can go to the left. Here we have 4, we know 4 is smaller than 32, so we have to go to the right. Here we have 20, 20 is smaller than 32, we go to the right. Here we have 30, and 32 is bigger, so we go to the right. Here it's null, so we know we have searched the whole tree and we haven't found our solution. So that reminds us a little bit on the binary search, because every time we do a comparison, we can basically disregard the other half, the other child, with all its descendants of the node. Right? By looking and comparing one time, we make a choice to which of the children to reiterate this process. And if you do this right, you can make a search tree in such a way that it's a balanced binary tree, then you get a worst case complexity of log n for the search, which is similar to our binary search. Let's have a look how we can generically implement a search tree, which is not balanced, because that's a little bit easier. How can we, by the way, implement a tree in the first place? Well, we can do this very conveniently with pointers. So assume we want to store as a value a number, and we know a tree node has two children, a left child and a right child. If they are set to something, the pointer will be basically point to this child node. If there is no child node, we initialize it with null. Okay, so that's basically matching this figure that we see here. Okay, and at the end, we have also a node structure and we have a tree structure. In the tree structure, we have a head node and we want to store how many nodes there are as a size, which is another data element. So when we initialize the tree, we allocate our tree data structure and initialize it with 0. Then we are done. We have a null as a head node. We have basically set it to null everywhere. And we have size as well initialized to 0. Now, how do we do the search? Well, the search algorithm is very simple. We can do this in a recursive algorithm. And let me show you how this can be done easily. And we have a tree search function. We want to return the node if this node exists, otherwise we return null. So we have to give it a tree that where we want to search for a given value. If the tree size is null, well, we return null because there's nothing to search. Otherwise, we call our internal function, which will start from the head node and search for the value. So now we are here at this head node, and basically we follow our algorithm. If the node is null, well, we return null. Otherwise, if the value is equal to our node value, so if we're searching for 42, we are done. If it is not, then we do our comparison. If the value is smaller than this node, we know we have to descend into the left side. That's what we do. So we do our tree search internal function on the left side with the same value. If it is bigger, we iterate to the right side. So this recursive algorithm will now follow the path until it finds the result or if it returns null. So the insertion is a little bit more tricky. So I, in this case, by the way, I made it so that we have to store this head node value explicitly. There are various loads of different implementations, of course, that work slightly different. I made a decision to make my own implementation like this. So first thing that we need to do is we have to create a new node because we want to insert a new value. So we initialize this node with 0, and then we set the value to be the value given by the user. Now we created this node. Now we have to find the spot inside the tree where we want to insert it. So how do we find it? Well, we have to traverse the tree, right? And so in this case, I have to remember the parent node of the node, because I have to insert a node on the parent. So I run again our traversal algorithm, but I will remember this time also the parent node. Once I found the spot where I have to insert it, I will basically stop, and then I have remembered the parent, and now I make the decision where to insert it in terms of the parent. So our new node that I just created, if it is smaller or equal than the parent value, I have to put it on the left side of the parent. If it is bigger, then I have to put it on the parent right side. That's all I need to do. And as this algorithm only terminates when it finds a null pointer, it will find the right spot. So let's have a try. In this case, I want to insert 32 again. So we know the algorithm traverses up to this point. So it found current is null, but the parent is this node. Now it does this last comparison. Is the parent value smaller or equal than the value I try to insert? In this case, no. So I have to follow the right side and I have to insert this new node at this spot. Note that this leads to degenerated search trees, this little algorithm, as it doesn't balance the tree, but nevertheless, it's a working example. So now you can think about how you could use the search tree that we just talked about for a sorting algorithm. And think also about what complexity the resulting sorting algorithm would have. The basic idea for this algorithm is that you want to insert all elements into the search tree, and then you perform an iteration over these nodes, so a normal traversal. This algorithm is called tree sort, and indeed we saw the complexity of it on our last lecture already when we discussed the different sorting algorithms. It has a complexity of n log n. Let's have a look how we have to do the tree traversal. Here I'll do a recursive in order tree traversal, and we will have a function per node that we try to execute. And we call this function the observer function. So we have again our traverse in order function that takes a tree, and it takes from the user this observer function, if set, which allows you to access the tree nodes. If the tree is empty, we have nothing to do. Otherwise, we call our internal function that starts from the head node and calls this observer. What does this kind of function do? Well, it does exactly what we need to do when we need to do an in-order traversal. So we traverse first the left node, then we run this observer function on the current node, then we traverse the right side. That's basically it. So it's really exactly the algorithm like we discussed, these traversals and the processing of the in order before. So now let's use our little search tree. Here I created a little function, node printer, which matches the signature of our observer. And all it does, it prints basically the value of the nodes. So how to use it? We initialize the tree and now we insert a couple of nodes. 42, 4, 102, 20, 30, 12, 203. And that will result in this tree on the right side. And after that, I will call tree traverse in order with our node printer function. And what it will print the in-order execution. So we will get, in this example, we will get 4, 12, 20, 30, 42, 102, and 203, which is exactly the sorting order. Well, let's have a look again. We start with the in-order, right? So we go to the left. Here we go to the left, nothing to do, so we have to print 4. Then we go to the right, go to the left, go to the left, nothing to do. We print 12, we go to the right, nothing to do. We go from here to the right. Here we have to go to the left, nothing to do, we print 30. So that's the execution up to this point. And you can see that it basically does a very nice sorting for us.